Hello, and welcome to this ArcherPoint presentation on Business Central Year-End Steps, Operations Calendars. My name is Alex Wiley. I'm a Senior Pre-Sales Consultant here at ArcherPoint, and I'm going to lead you through this demo today. Today, we're going to look at the two main calendars that are used for operations, which are our base calendars. These are assigned to locations and show when we can ship or receive products at a given location. And then we have our shop calendars, which are assigned to our work centers and drive when production is scheduled. Let's go ahead and look at our work centers. If you're already using production and work centers today, you should have already had your work center set up with your shop calendars and your capacity was already scheduled. However, moving into the new year, if you haven't calculated the capacity and availability for these moving forward, we often get contacted that there's an error that people can't schedule production or that they're getting an error when they run MRP or MPS. So today we're going to look at how to avoid that. Want to go back to our shop calendars. We go to related shop calendar, working days. Verify your working days, starting and ending times are all correct and how you want to have availability for the assigned work center. Then go to related shop calendar holidays. This is where you can establish your holidays for the coming year. So for example, here I've blocked off July 4th. Once my holidays are set, I go back to my Work Center page and I go to Process, Calculate Work Center Calendar. Again, this is an important step, even if you haven't added any holidays or made any adjustments, because you want to make sure that your capacity is scheduled and available for the coming year. So we say OK. And now this is going to go through using my calendars and create the capacities, and of course, removing the days that I listed as holidays. So we updated July 4th for our 24-hour shift for our drying room. Let's go ahead and go into Process and Calendar. I'm going to go back and look at the period with July 4th for 2024. Say Show Matrix. And now if I go over, I can see that it's calculated my capacities for all the other days of 2024, except it is omitted July 4th. So this is a good area to go in and check and make sure that your weekends are blocked off and any other holidays that you've assigned to other shifts were properly accepted. And now you can schedule production on those days. Now let's look at our base calendars. Here is where I can review my standard calendars, seeing my non-working days, and if I go to Actions, Functions, Maintain Base Calendar Changes, here's where I can set specific days that I want to block off. Again, let's use July 4th, 2024. Now this is marked as a non-working day. If I go and look at my locations, I can now make sure that my calendars are assigned. And for my locations, if there's specific days at specific locations you want to block off, you can go in and do that here. All I do is select Edit, set it as non-working, and then I can put a description for why that's a non-working day. Unlike your shop calendars, you don't have to run anything to update this. However, any sales or purchase orders that previously existed might have had this day selected. So it's a good idea to update this as soon as possible so that your existing sales and purchase documents don't need to be updated. That's how you update your calendars. If you have any questions, please feel free to leave a comment or reach out to us here at ArcherPoint so that we can help you. Thank you.